Robles is about to go live online. Catch the Concert Series, the premier live music program on Philippine Radio. Monday evenings on The Monster. Streaming video on The Monster Facebook page at RX931. The Monster YouTube channel at RX931. And twitch.tv/MonsterRX931. Your Concert Series host, Rico Robles. Stand by and enjoy the program.
Studios. Why? Because it is the anniversary special of The Monster. And who do we got in store? Well, she is coming up next. She's right next to me, actually. From Orange County to Ortigas Center is where she's at. From way, way back. We go way, way back in the times when, let's just say, she was associated with Timbaland. And now it's all about the king of R&B in the Philippines. That's what it's all about. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. In the Monster Studios, we have her live. Give it up for Mika Javier.
Everything right, unnecessary, but on the contrary, doesn't matter anyway. Have it your way, go miss the pace. I would say there is no one else to blame. You're so insecure, there is no cure. Honest, let's be honest. I don't want this right now. Be there when you try to deflect. Don't wanna try to fake no more smiles. Unnecessary, but on the contrary, it doesn't matter anyway. Have it your way, go miss the pain. I would say there is no one else to blame. You're so insecure, there is no cure. No, 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 honest. Let's be honest, I don't want this right now. Honest, let's be honest, moving on from this right now. If I'm honest, babe, don't want you here, don't need you near. If I'm honest, babe, hey, nobody wants to be around you. Nobody wants to tell you no. Nobody likes playing your mind. Yeah. You're a fool thinking you can get anywhere the way you do. Honestly,
let's be honest. Right now.
Can I get through to you?
Right now,
wanna be honest, babe. Wanna be honest. Ooh, I just
Yeah, all about being honest. Is that the theme of the album? All I know is welcome back to the concert series, Mika. One of the strong ladies that I know. That's you, man.
Wow, thank you.
And I've known you for quite some time.
I know. And you know some stuff.
For the powerhouse of what you guys do with Homeworks, of course, every king needs a queen. And I think it's an honor for you to be here joining us. Come a long way from the last time we spoken to each other. It was all about a corazón and heart song.
Oh my gosh, you've really known me for so long.
You know,
that was my first single ever, the solo single, heart song.
I mean, were you part of a girl group before?
Not before that. I was part of a girl group when I was on Showtime, when I was live on Showtime, dancing and stuff.
And you know, with that one, when you were doing that Showtime and all that journey, I mean, you guys have gone through so much.
I feel like a different person. I feel like that was a completely different version of myself now.
Yung sobrang ano. Oh my God, this is going to be a fun interview. I'm going to touch on everything. Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Okay, so after Heart Song.
And also, wait, just like fun fact, Heart Song went number one on this on this show. Or
on
this station.
Yeah, monster.
So thank you, RX, for supporting me from day one.
Because it's a beautiful song.
Thank you.
You know, it's so, ano yun, haka-addict siyang pakinggan. Alam mo yung, sinasabihin ko pa siya with Jessica Simpson's Public Affair.
Oh, cool. Yeah, yeah.
It's that kind of feeling. But, you know, the journey for you, of course, when you started in your music, how did it all start for you? Did you try to join a reality show?
I never tried to join any show, any reality, any contest. Mm-hmm. I just started making music. Mm-hmm. I was in my, you know, dorm room in college, and my neighbors were students from the Clive Davis program in NYU.
Okay.
And so they're doing their homework, they're making music, and then I'm there with my guitar, like, hey, can we make a song together? Mm-hmm. And then from there, I really wanted to pursue making original music against all odds. Even, you know, my family wasn't really supportive of that because entertainment wasn't what...
I mean, your family was known for chicken
exactly,
and clothes.
Business.
And island clothes.
Island you know clothes.
Right? Didn't you have a business like that?
Was Tito Danny's business.
Yeah, your family. Like, but for you guys, it's chicken.
Yeah, it's chicken. Uh-huh. And so being a daughter of someone that owns a chicken chain... It was
Shout out, music.
You really into music, girl. So it was quite a journey for me because I had to fight for that. I really had to fight to be me and to be an artist and to do what I want.
Was your parents strict about it? Did they like, you know?
Yeah, my dad was he's a businessman. Mm-hmm. So that's his road to success was through business. Mm-hmm. And so he, of course, wanted the best. For his children also, he wants the best for us. So he wants to apply the same thing for us. Mm-hmm. And he gave us the education and all of that, the experience. And it just turns out every kid has a different interest. Mine just so happened to be entertainment.
And that's passion.
Yeah.
Now, the hard part is, especially now, you know, y'all think it's only now that you are going through this. But we've been struggling on this, is trying to pursue our passion with our parents saying, hey, you should be this, you should be
that. Exactly.
How did you convince your parents to let you do what you do?
I didn't. I just did it. Uh-huh. And, you know, it caused a lot of rifts in my family, even just like struggle, just acceptance and kind of in the Filipino culture, right? You have to obey your parents and stuff. I kind of rebelled a little bit and found my way somehow, lost my way and then found my way back. But I think when other people started recognizing my work and then circling back around and telling my dad, oh, nakita ko yung anak mo dun sa show. Yung ganito, oh, yung anak mo, yung... Like, when it becomes like that, it's not coming from you, the child, that you will always be a child to your parents.
That's right.
When it comes from their peers, I feel like it makes a better impact on them. Uh-huh. So they start to appreciate and accept it easier, I think.
And with your dad accepting it, I mean, you know, in comes, of course, that confidence of getting your music out. Now, when you wanted to do, you know, the whole working with Timbaland and all that, I mean, when you play a guitar, you were doing R&B while playing guitar?
No, I was doing like Michelle Branch kind of music.
Remember
back in the day?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, so mga acoustic, because I used to write songs like that. But I was also a dancer growing up, so folk kind of music got I got really bored with it fast.
Because you cannot dance with a guitar.
Yeah, like, I mean, you can. Like, people be doing it nowadays. Yeah. But I was also very interested in just the musicality of R&B, hip-hop, and pop. Just straight-up pop. And for some reason, it was hard for me to find music people that could create the sound that I wanted.
So you got to do it yourself. That's
right. So, yeah, I fell into that camp. And they did a production deal with me to try to develop like a Filipino artist at the time.
Okay, so we're going to go through this story of this in just a bit. Okay, yeah. So for today, we're going to hear some songs.
Yeah.
And what are the songs you're going to be performing for us today?
So I'm performing majority of the songs that were on my album and also the singles that I released after the album.
All right.
And then I also have one new song.
Hey, gotta get an exclusive.
Fresh from LA.
Hey, look at that.
And it's my new single. It's called Too Good. And it just came out last Saturday.
So fresh. All right, cool. Yeah. So Amoy State special.
Oh, Amoy State special.
As they do say.
Okay, with a twang.
What are the next two songs you got for us?
The next two songs are Love Is and Laruan. So Love Is was a pandemic single. I recorded and shot everything during the quarantine times. So that was so crazy. That was an experience too.
Right. Yeah. We got to see your house. Check out our interview with them, with their whole house tour, by the way.
Yeah. So I released that one 2021. And then Laruan, I released 2019, right after I shot Los Bastardos, a teleserye. It's a Tagalog song and it's an empowerment. It's like a women empowerment song.
All right. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We have her live. Mika Javier joining us once again. If you have any questions, you have any shout outs to her at RX931, you can put it on the screen as well. 0961-367-931. Here we go. Live tonight, the concert series. I'll hear on the Monster.
I'm calling, so pick up, yeah. There's more to it, my heart's in it. At the end of the day, it's forever, so pick up, oh. See, you're better than I could imagine, yeah. You're everything I wanted, I can have it, that's fine. Yeah, love is patient, unexpected kind. It's you that call waving instantaneous. And I wouldn't trade it. Less forgiving, gentle can be kind. It's so different every time you baby. Let's trust. Love is us. Love is. Love is us. Love is. I'm a baddie to a slappy. Never thought I'd be this happy, no. I never thought it could ever happen. The way you love me, it's like magic. They should better than I could imagine. Ooh. You're everything I want and I can have it, that's fine. Yeah, love is patient, unexpected kind. It's you like a wave and it's contagious. And I wouldn't trade it. Love's forgiving, gentle can be kind. It's so different every time you baby. That's trust. Love is us. Love is. Love is us. Love is. Love is us. Oh. Love is. Yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Patient kind on your mind. Patient kind. Oh, that's what love is. It's you like a wave and it's contagious. I wouldn't trade it, no. Love is us, love is us, love is us, love
mga pangakong di totoo ng tulad mong balatiyo. Nilimot ang sarili ko sa'yo binigay, ngayon ay nagsisisi, di ko na mahintay. Nasabihin mo na gusto at tapusin na ito. Di na bale kung mawawala ka man, sapat na sakin paulit-ulit mong saktan. Kung sakaling di mo man alam, ako'y babae at hindi na lupan. Sana ay nalaman ko ako ang iyong mundo. Nakulakulagan at hindi matangga, lahat ng pinakita mo ay pagpapangga. Hindi ka na gusto tatapusin na ito. Di na bale kung mawawala ka man, sapat na sakin paulit-ulit mong saktan. Kung sakaling di mo man alam, ako'y babae at hindi laruan. Hinahayaan ang sarili ko mahulog pang muli sa isang katulad mo. Di nang hihinayang, di na umaasang magbabago ka. Ngayon magpapasya. Di na pala mawawala ka man. Kung sa pala babae, di na bale paulit-ulit, di mo man alam, ako'y babae at hindi laruan.
Yeah, anthem, the anthem of the ladies. That's what it's all about.
Don't Mika play with
air.
Us, ladies.
The concert series, we've been talking about her journey. Now, for those that are tuning in, it's, of course, our anniversary special straight from Orange County now to Ortega Center. Joining us, walang jet lag. Wala naman.
May jet lag pa.
Yeah. Okay, so, you know, of course, Los Bastardos, it was such a journey for you.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of action scenes.
Oh, yeah.
I watch your stories on IG as well, and the way you prepare for it.
Oh,
I mean, you know, in everything they do say in your journey, ano yung takeaway mo doon? Did it, you know, especially with the acting side?
Honestly, the acting was the last art that I wanted to try. Mm-hmm. It was the one that was least interesting to me. But surprisingly, I tried every single thing. I modeled, sang, danced, lahat. Pagdating sa acting,
mm-hmm.
parang dun pa ako nag-click.
Uh-huh.
Parang late bloomer. I discovered it very, very late.
Mm-hmm.
But I fell in love with it because I felt like I could really express myself in so many different ways.
Mm-hmm.
And it was also a form of therapy for me.
Uh-huh.
That's kind of weird to say. But like, yeah, it really, really did help me work through a lot of my inner stuff. Like mm-hmm. all my frustrations, all of my joys or my sadness, I can put it into a character. And I feel like that's why it worked so well for me. And the audience could feel it when they would watch me.
So did it make better music videos for you now? Na parang, uy, may acting chops ka na.
I think so. I think, yeah, just in general, just being aware of yourself and a little bit more confidence in front of a camera or in front of people. I really think it helped. Being on Showtime helped a lot.
Kasi I mean,
sabak ka talaga sa...
On the daily basis.
Yeah, daily live. That
now,
was
you know,
so crazy.
Speaking of that journey, of course, you're part of the girl group. What's the name of the girl group?
Girl Trends.
Girl Trends. And it became GT. I think you guys did it for a bit. Now with that one, I mean, I remember guessing you guys here.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, when it has all the girls in one group, I could imagine how crazy
hard.
It is. Especially you're the musically inclined one
yeah.
out of the group. kumbaga, ikaw yung, you had your production stuff, you went to school for it, and yeah. then being, sasaba ka ngayon sa lunchtime variety
exactly.
show.
Exactly. Tapos hindi mo kontrolado kung anong gagawin nila.
Yes. I mean, I can imagine, may documentary ba kayo? May awayan? That would have been a great reality show.
That's what you were
show.
Saying. Yeah, you were like, you should do a reality show.
Reality show. Ikaw ba din quiet one? Are you the one na, may mga characters yun?
I was
yun,
the manang. I was the ate. Like, you know, like, parang, hindi ako leader ng group because there's a leader. There's a leader of the group. But I felt like all the girls, like, confided in me and was, like, asking for advice all the time. And, yeah, I felt like I was my typical manang role. I'm the eldest of, like, so many kids. So.
And how was it being joined?
It was natural for me.
How's it being joined in the group? How did GT, yeah, how did it? Was it formed? I mean, Girl Trends, is it like, oh, pa audition tayo?
Dude, we went through an intense audition process. Uh-huh. LMD, Direct LMD, had us going through the studio, the sound stages in ABS. Mm-hmm. There were maybe like 200 girls at first, and then one by one, you learn, group by group, you learn choreography, and then they eliminate. They kept eliminating until there were like 22 girls left. Uh-huh. And when we launched, there were 22 girls. In the group, and then it became 14, and then it became 8, and then it became 7. I think we ended up with 5, 7, 6, something like this.
And I remember you guys guesting on the show as well when you guys were all singing in the group.
Because the thing is with that, we were all individual artists in ABS.
True.
We were under Star Magic or some sort of manager situation, and they were forming the group to make something happen on the show, like something interesting. So we didn't know the extent to what the group was to be. Like, are we gonna be a group off cam also? Are we gonna only be a group on Showtime? What about on other shows? So it was weird because on Showtime we were a group. Outside of Showtime, we were individual artists.
So ano nga yun eh? Kumbaga confusing nga in a way as an artist na. Okay, am I gonna get marketed by myself? Paano kung isa lang yung may racket?
Exactly.
Nagkaaroon ba ng selosan?
Meron yun, for sure. Tsaka agawan yun ng position, di ba?
Mga choreography. Dude, if y'all only produced the reality show of that group, dude, that would have been real, keeping up with Girl Trends. Oh my God.
Oh, that would have been a riot.
Dude, that would have been it. Yung mga dramatic. Yeah. Pero, of course, naging viral kayo. With the dance.
Oh, yeah. I still get haunted by my dreams.
And the memes are out. You know, how did Mika Javier handle that?
I did not handle it very well. I got very stressed. I like to train and prepare myself for anything that's going to be put out like that. And I just didn't have the chance to. So the day we did that performance, galing akong taping, Los Bastardos, 5 a.m. na yata kami nakauwi. Or mga 4. Tapos ang call time sa ABS, 8 a.m. Aaralin mo yung sayaw at yung kanta, which they send like the day before. And then 12 o'clock noon, salang, opening prod. So I didn't have any sleep. Like
it was stressful.
It was stressful. They were teaching it too fast. And then you have to get ready, hair, makeup, and all of this. And we just were not prepared. And what do you do? Like when the doors open and you're live, you just have to go and you just have to do it. And so here's the thing too. If you know the counts and you're on beat, but someone messes up, it could be anybody.
Yeah.
Who do you follow? Like on camera? Cause
my camera, on beat.
Diba? So kung katabi mo, iba yung galaw, sasabayan mo ba yung mali or susunod ka dun sa beat? Hindi mo alam kung ano gagawin.
That is tricky.
Yeah, so we were constantly doing that on the show. And it was so hard. I don't think I've ever been bashed that hard in my life. It was scary. People are so mean online.
What's the harshest you've heard?
What the harshest?
Without cursing.
Oh, there was a lot of cursing.
Ano yung harshest at ano yung isa na alala mo na sobrang galing, na sobrang bait ng tao na yun, na para bang na-inspire ka din?
Saan?
Like, you know, what was that message from a fan? I'm sure there's a lot of
bash. That was
harsh? Yeah, there was harsh. And there's some good ones too that you can remember.
I really don't remember anything specific, but it was just parang you work so hard to build yourself and your name and your character and the quality of the work that you do. And with one bad performance, it's like ripped down and parang yung credibility mo, yung kakayanan mo, erase agad sa mata ng tao, yun yung masakit. Because it's like, dang, you don't even know what we go through behind the scenes.
True. And you, of course, through the years of being in music and then now being put in national spotlight and the biggest show in
the meantime. On TV. And also being educated. Yeah. Like, you're an educated person. And then you're getting all of these messages na parang wala kayong kwenta. But
so what's your takeaway in that? What did you, you know, they do say that in every stage of your life that you go through, you take away something that you take with you now.
Well, my takeaway was, there was a lot, but a few that really stick with me is always be prepared. Mm-hmm. The show must go on. You can't please everybody. Mm-hmm. And you just have to work on yourself so much that you just exude that goodness and that confidence in whatever you do, so that even if people say negative stuff about you, you're happy with what you did.
At pumawi ka sa acting.
Oo naman.
Oh, diba? Sabi ko, diba?
Sige, wala akong control dyan.
Dito ako sa pag-acting.
Dito ako sa acting na lang ako.
And then Los Bastardos was such a big show.
I know, I didn't realize.
Dude, that's a blessing for you.
It was such a huge blessing.
Because, you know, he already knows you go in music. So you know, I'm going to put you in a messed up group.
No, but honestly, I wouldn't
focus on your acting.
Yeah, I wouldn't change a thing, because being in that group and on Showtime taught me everything that I needed to learn to be successful in this crazy industry, not just here, but also elsewhere, or even in like in the States and stuff.
It's open for a reunion?
Yeah, that would be so fun.
Do it, and then do that dance.
Yeah,
just
we'll do that dance, and we'll do it properly this time.
Yeah. That'd be cool. That'd be cool, right?
Yeah, but you know, we all grew up also. I'm still friends with most of them. A lot of them have, you know, gone separate ways. But it's so nice to see everybody grow.
But
and it's nice to see that you shouldn't be defined by the one thing that you did.
True.
Everyone like finds their way.
Boost you guys up in a national spotlight that needed to happen so your acting could level up.
Yeah.
And now you're here, married life and all. We'll talk about that in just a bit. How's it being married to the king of R&B in the Philippines? We'll talk about that. Is he a slave master in the studio? We'll talk about that in just a bit. What are the next two songs you got for us?
Okay, the next song is actually going to be my single. It's out now. It just was released a few days ago. Mm-hmm. This is the first song that I'm releasing in like 2 years. Mm-hmm. I kind of took a break from music because I got burned out. I got frustrated. I felt uninspired. We moved to the States. It was so chaotic. I couldn't focus on anything. So can I tell that fun story about the Timbaland? Okay, so we have an apartment, right, in LA. Mm-hmm. One day, I was going up to the steps of the apartment. I was waiting for my Postmates delivery, para Uber Eats, Grab food. Mm-hmm. Tapos pag antay ko, biglang may nakaupong mama dun sa steps. Mm-hmm. He had dreadlocks. He was like looking down like this. So I went up and I said, excuse me, I just have to make
pass
my way.
By, yeah.
He looks up at me and he stares at me like this. And he's like, are you Mika? Mm-hmm. And I stopped and I was like, why do you know my, like, first of all, why do you know my name? You're in my apartment. This is creepy. Uh-huh. Who the F is this, basically? And then I looked at it and I was like, oh my God, it's M Quest. Mm-hmm. M Quest was my producer when I was signed to Timbaland Productions. He disappeared from the face of the earth. Mm-hmm. He left music for a while. He also had the same journey of like, not
self-discovery.
Yeah, self-discovery, not really being happy with the business, got, you know, getting bad deals and all that stuff. He disappeared. He left. Couldn't get a hold of him. He changed his name back. You know, producers change their name. Mm-hmm. He changed his name back to his real name. Mm-hmm. So I really couldn't find him. So then we met and I was like, wait, what are you doing here? He's like, I just moved into this building a week ago.
Mm-hmm. So this is in LA?
In LA. Uh-huh. This happened a few months ago.
Uh-huh. Wow.
So we were like, we walked out of a portal and bumped into each other. There's a million buildings in LA. There's a million producers. How did I end up meeting this guy again? Mm-hmm. And we had unfinished business because, you know, we got ripped apart.
I moved
to the Philippines and then he disappeared.
Then you find yourself back
in
the States.
Yeah, but all my best music back in the day was made by him and done by him. The only person that got close to making music like that with me is JR. For real. Like, I'm not even kidding.
Oh, yeah. That's true love.
Yeah.
That's destiny.
And then, so anyways, long story short, he convinced me to get back in the studio and write music again. So we're working on a whole album together.
Is this one of the songs?
This is not one of the songs, but this is a song that I had already for a while.
Okay.
So I had it reproduced and like gave it a fresh flavor.
He did the reproduction of this one?
No, another producer friend of ours, Mike Manny. Shout out, Mike.
Dami niyong barkada.
But I figured I should start releasing music again before I come out with all the new stuff.
Yes.
So that it kind of bridges the gap because I wasn't releasing music for a while.
Yes, we've been waiting.
Yeah.
The charts are waiting.
So this song is called Too Good. It's my new single. It's out on all platforms now. And RX will be playing it too.
Sure. And what's the next one after that?
Next one after that is Heart Song.
All right. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We got her live once again. Mika Javier, the concert series.
Please stop, yeah, I'm coming for you. I'll be there soon, yeah, soon, yeah, soon. You wait up, yeah, I'ma change your life. Oh, stay with me, let me show ya. I'm right around the corner, yeah, and I'ma change your life. I am the best thing you'll ever have. I am the best thing you never had. I change that. I could change that. What I give, you give it back. And that's something you never had, no. Let's change that. I can change that. We're chemistry. Don't let it slip away. I'm burning up, yeah, honestly, it's fire. Just you and me. It's much more than you can take. But you ain't gonna want nothing else for me. Yeah, I'll make it too good. Too good for you. Too good. I'll make it too good, too good for you, too good. There ain't no telling how far we'll go. I'm into trying things we don't know. I do it for you, I do it for, I do it for you. You're the best thing I'll ever have. You're the best thing I never had. Let's change that. You can change that. Yeah. Oh, stop, let me show you. I'm right around the corner, yeah. And I might change your life. Woo! Let it slip away. I'm burning up, yeah, honestly, it's fire. Just you and me, it's much more than you can take. But you ain't gonna hold nothing else but me. Yeah. Too good, hey, too good for you. Too good, too good, yeah. You're the best thing I've ever had. Let's change that. You can change that. I'm the best thing you'll ever have. I'm the best thing you never had. Let's change that. You can change that. What I give, you give it back. And that's something you never had. No. Let's change that. I can change that. Yeah.
You are my heart song. Woo! I gotta hear you, cause you're my heart song.
It's the OG right here.
You are my heart song.
No.
You're my heart song. You are my heart song. You are my heart song.
Javier joining us. See, Dua Lipa, watch out. Before you came out with your tracks, it was her. She yeah. just, yeah, she just had to take a
little
break.
Ahead of our time there. Right? I think.
She just had to take a break and focus on acting. That's what it's all about. Now, in comes, of course, you know, Married Life.
Yeah.
I saw that. I just saw the video of that. Habang Buhay. The whole proposal thing. How did that feel when everybody was dancing there? Then he got down and
yo, I had no idea what was happening. Uh-huh. You know me, like it's on set, we're working. I'm trying to be professional.
Did you know it was a video music shoot?
Yeah, I knew it was a music video shoot. That's why I was like, I'm professional. Uh-huh. Okay, everybody's moving away. I'm gonna move away too. Yun pala, surprise.
Barintong si JR, no?
Yeah, and you know what's so funny? See, this is what I'm saying about people online. They be so mean. Uh-huh. They were like, ay, hindi ready si girl. Walang reaction si girl. Napilitan si girl. I was like, dude, I had no idea. So yung mukha ko talagang RBF to the fullest. But because I was like, is this real?
Is it part of the music video?
I was not briefed. And then when I started seeing everybody with their phones, and then I looked at JR, he was on one knee and he was tearing up. I was like, oh. Wait.
Pacha umiiyak.
Parang totoo.
Di naman marunong umarte yun. Parang not part of the script yun.
Yeah, so yeah, it hit me kind of late. But I didn't even hear what he said.
I mean, you said, I do.
Yeah, I was like, yes! It's in the video. Watch Habang Buhay on YouTube, the music video. It's all there.
Pero you know, your story, kayong dalawa ni JR, I mean, before the proposal and all that. I mean, we never got to know. Paano ba naligaw ang isang JR. Nung time mayon, may billboard pa siya sa EDSA na naka-brief.
Wala, hindi ko nakita yun.
Wala pa siya, no? Naka-brief yun sa EDSA.
Yun nga yung maganda eh, kasi lahat ng billboards niya, tsaka yung pinaka super exposed si JR in the scene.
May prutas pa yung isa na, ito sa magazine.
Yeah, the green apples. I was not here. Uh-huh. I was not in the Philippines, so I did not see all of that. Uh-huh. So I got to know JR on my own terms, kind of. Not because I knew him as a celebrity. I didn't even know he was a celebrity.
He was, or Chris Brown.
Yeah, that's what I said. So he performed at the Apple the App charity event where we met. And then, so I actually went up to him first. I was like, hey, oh, shoot, I don't know you. Sorry, my bad.
And it's like, you stop, mom.
Yeah. Tapos bigla siyang nag-perform. Pag tapos niya, lumabas siya sa stage. So I go, wow, you sing so good. You sound like Chris Brown. Uh-huh. I was like, is that an original song? He was like, yeah, it's my original song.
Was it Design for Love?
No, it was Follow Me. Of those like fast songs. Uh-huh. And I was like, dude, I make music too. Uh-huh. And at that moment in time, I went to a few labels already here, mm-hmm. major labels. And they all kind of like turned me down mm-hmm. because I was singing in English. Mm-hmm. My music sounded Americanized.
It's too social for the market, as they do say.
And I wasn't doing covers. Mm-hmm. So when I met him and he understood what I was doing, mm-hmm. we just clicked. And then, so you're asking, anong style niya mangligaw?
Like, iba kasi yung iba producer, we're working music together, making beats. Pero iba yung, I want to get to know you.
No, but that's what he did though. Uh-huh. He was like, oh, let's get in the studio. Let's make some music together. Uh-huh. And the song that we did when we did make music together was Tonight, which became our number one song too.
Yeah, the disco thing. Right?
Yeah, that one. So he did use the studio as the moves. But he was legit. It wasn't no.
Na-invite niya na ako sa studio na yun. You're making moves, ha? Yun.
Pares kayong kalbo. Yun nangyari.
We shine together. You know?
No, but then, you know what was cool though? Uh-huh. When I finally learned that he was this, the biggest R&B king of R&B Philippines star, the way he treated me in the beginning and in front of his fans, without his fans, in the Philippines, not in the Philippines, was exactly the same. So he was consistent from day one. The JR that was introduced to me in the beginning is still the JR that I married. So
I mean, with marriage life, you guys now moving to the States and back music wise. So thank you for coming back to music. I think, you know, we miss you.
That
music
means a lot to me.
Yes. It's about
that. I was
time.
So insecure about it.
Dude, welcome back.
Thank you.
All right. And it's an anniversary special. That's for you to get back here, to let us hear new tracks and, you know, for everything to be aligned.
Yeah.
Even the people.
Even that story, right? Yeah. Like, there's no way. Parang yun sign na yun sa universe na, hoy, anong ginagawa mo?
Yun na yun.
Make some music, please.
Diba? Kasi, and she's the lady that got me into TikTok, by the way. Silang what? Dalawa. Yung mga dance-dance sila, natawa ko, uy, dami ng views. Makapag-TikTok na. And then I got into that because of you guys.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, cool. You guys are like such a power TikTok couple. You know what I mean? So, what's in store for all the fans? Okay, so the new music is gonna come out. When is this? When's the drop of the new album?
We're doing it single by single. So just, I guess, stay tuned. Like, follow me on my social media. I'll keep you posted there, so that there's
music video. When's this?
Oh, I don't know.
Have one in roller skates.
Yo, I have a music video for Too Good already. It's gonna come out really soon. And guess what? I shot and edited the video myself.
Okay.
Actually, my videographer was JR. This is what happened. It was my birthday. We went to Palm Springs. Okay. It's like the desert, right?
Like Coachella vibes.
But then on the last day, we extended. We were like, why don't we just shoot like a guerrilla style music video? So we found a random like desert looking area and we just shot it there.
So shayong sayaw.
Yeah.
Back there, huh?
Yeah, because I've never done that before. I've never shot a music video for myself by myself with no help.
And how?
And then edit everything.
So how did it turn out? The perfectionist that you are.
I think it wasn't bad for something that was like that, like shot like that. I'm not a professional in that way, but I'm pretty proud of what it came to be. So you guys will see it really soon. Just follow me on social media. Mika on Instagram, The Real Mika on TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, all that.
You know you made when you have a check beside your name and it's just one name, like Kobe. Like, you know what I mean?
I got Mika.
Right? Jealous of that.
I got lucky.
Right? No last name. But hey, congratulations to everything. And of course, people will ask, when's, you know, is there any baby plans now? What's the plan for you guys?
I think it's up to the universe. Okay. But I'm ready for it though when it does come.
Hey, it's just the music. Get that music.
It's the music.
Yeah.
You know, it keeps us young, it keeps us energized. Mm-hmm. So hopefully.
When I watch you guys and your stories and your outfit checks, and I do it, I'm telling you, I know so much of your social media lives, both of y'all, because it's so interesting. You guys always come up with something fresh.
Wait, so can I ask you, do you think there's a difference between our content from the Philippines and then the US?
Yes. Social na mga damit ninyo.
Eh di magaling.
Pupunta ka lang ng grocery, ganda na ng outfit.
What? No way!
Yung mga ganun, I saw one, I think you were going to like a concert or something, and you had like a hat, and you had your mini skirt, and then you had like a black net top, I think. If I could recall it. Did I get it right?
Yeah, I think I know what outfit you're talking about.
See?
You're good.
Yeah, details. I check out what y'all do. I was like, okay, mga
trippy. It's different kasi iba din yung taste sa US. Yes. Yung audience dun iba din. So we're trying to bridge the gap, you know?
Yeah, you're doing a great job.
Thank you.
All right. So in store once again for the rest of the year, a bunch of singles. Any major concerts?
Not at the moment, but something that I can also share is we're working on a feature film that is in post-production right now. And we're working with Hollywood people for that. It's produced by me and JR. It's a family affair.
Okay.
The same people behind Quezon's Game, if you heard
of that movie. Yes, of course. That's Mr. Raymond Bagaching. Yeah, I interviewed him here. So
the same production that did that, we worked with them on this film. And
Malalim na Tagalog.
It's in English majority.
Oh, malam na English.
It's about the dark side of the music industry.
Oh, wow. So, in the Philippines.
In the Philippines. Okay. Based off a lot of true stories. Yeah. Sayang nga eh. But no, but because it was, we shot it pre-pandemic.
Oh, okay. Congratulations on
thank
this,
you.
Huh?
So please look
is
out
gonna
for
that.
Is
going to be on a festival somewhere?
Yeah, we're trying to work on getting that all that sorted.
Holla, we'll talk off air and get you guys more exclusives in the bit. But thank you. It is the Monster Anniversary Month, of course. Many of the monsters tuned in, wishing you, you know, on being back. Any message?
Happy anniversary, monsters, first of all. And my message to you is whatever it is that you love to do and you're passionate about, go for it. Like, don't even bother with what other people say, their opinions. If you love it, work hard for it. You'll do well doing something that you love. And it'll keep you young and it'll keep you happy. And the money will follow.
Thank you, Mika. And don't forget to get some lechon back.
Wow, that rhymed.
All right. But what's the last song you got for us?
Last song is Dreamer. It's the title track of my album, in my first album. And I called it Dreamer because back then I was just dreaming about becoming an artist. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to inspire other people to do the same. You know, if you have something, you know, most people get told no more often than not. So yeah, just go for it.
Like for you, what's the advice that, you know, that when people say no, what was that advice you would give to people when, what kept you going? If people close the door on you, they're saying your demo wasn't good enough or this wasn't good enough.
Honestly, my answer to that would always change over time. But now it's whenever a door closes or someone says no to you, it's not for you. Mm-hmm. And it's literally a redirection for where you're meant to go. So with that in mind, it doesn't feel as bad. Because it's like, baka hindi para sa'yo yon. May mas maganda pa para sa'yo. So continue doing that thing, get better at it, learn from the feedback, you know, and don't get discouraged by the feedback because the feedback is actually going to help you be better. Mm-hmm. You'll figure out how to be improved and, you know, like just keep going. And eventually your vibe will attract your tribe. So when that happens, then you're golden.
All right. See, thank you very much. I mean, this is where you go mic drop, but we can't drop the mic. So ladies and gentlemen, to cap off, of course, our anniversary special, leave you with another track from Mika Javier here on the Concert Series.
When I sleep talk, I never get lost when I sleepwalk.
In my head, it all makes sense to me.
I'm always on time when the clock's off, so why you trying to wake me up from
out this state I'm in?
When I close my eyes, I'm wide awake, cause this dream I'm in is the life I'll take. My reality isn't the one you fake. With me, I see how. I'm a dreamer. I'm a dreamer. I'm a dreamer.
Don't close the door. Open your mind. Release your thoughts to the sky. And do not be afraid. No. You'll be in a better place as long as you can say that I
make more sense when I sleep talk. I never get lost when I sleepwalk.
In my head, it all makes sense to me.
I'm always on time when the clock's off, so why you trying to wake me up from
out this state I'm in? Oh, when I close my eyes, wide awake, yeah.
Reality isn't the one you
say.
When they ask me how, all I can say is I'm a dreamer.
Dreamer,
dreamer.
I'm a dreamer.
I'm a dreamer.
I'm a dreamer.
A dreamer.
I'm a dreamer.
A dreamer.
Here we go. If you think that I'm a so I'm gone in my time and I'm stuck in my chest. I'm not trying for these pages, these women, these bitches. They all in my mind, you would think it was this. My grandma's like physical fitness. Oh my god, I'm too good at this. conversation. Look, I go to sleep with a champagne fragrance. I wake up on champagne pieces. But we'll never get old, one like champagne. Money to the city, you know, for the high stakes. Think about the day that we're afraid. You ain't got a head start in the fairway. Eyes closed, I can see about 10 years. Yeah.
When I close
my eyes, I'm wide awake.
The Concert Series, the premier live musical variety program on radio. Winner of the KBP Golden Dove Award and the Catholic Mass Media Award. Mondays 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. on this station with the best radio specials. Monster RX 93.1.